Hi, I am Mary Ho, and I am the Executive Director of All Nations Family here in Kansas City. And today I want to share with you about leadership, how to raise up the next generation of young leaders. In my experience, almost everyone wants to be a leader. And we usually want to be the kind of leader that our heroes are. And for me, my hero is Bessie Stockton. She was an African-American lady in the early 1800s, and she felt a call to be a missionary at a time when very few African-Americans were going into missions, and almost no single ladies were going into missions. She had an impossible dream. But finally, in 1823, she went to Hawaii, to the island of Maui, and she established the first indigenous school there. And then she went on to raise up local leaders who took over the school after she left. Bessie Stockton was a leader that raised up other leaders. And she raised up ordinary men and women to be the leaders and to be the heroes. So as a leader, we are to be hero makers, were to raise up ordinary people to be heroes. There are five key steps in raising up leaders. The first one is, as leaders, we have to model the way. We have to be good examples by the way we act, by the way we talk, and by the way we live out our everyday life, from our home life to our public life. The second step is to inspire a shared vision among the people you lead. And so this involves vision casting and being able to mobilize people to follow a common purpose and a common vision. But for me, this step is more than that. It is to have the ability to see a person and to see a vision of what they can become and how they could reach their maximum potential. So I always look for inner eyes to see what a person can become in their future and to draw it out of them. Most people often cannot see their potential and what they can become. And sometimes they need others around them to call out their strengths, to call out their vision, and to say, I can see you being the best high school teacher, or I can see you becoming a lawyer, or I can see you make a difference in this sector. The next step is to encourage the heart. And again, I look for ways to call out a person's strength. I look for opportunities to affirm a job well done and to draw out their strengths. We all need a community around us who can encourage us in the way we should go. The next step is enabling others to act. And this is, as leaders, to create opportunities for others to have a way to serve or to take the next step. Sometimes that means that we have to make ourselves get in the background and let others come to the foreground. Sometimes it means that we can do some things well, but we allow others to have an opportunity to try it and to develop their skills. And the last step is to challenge the process. It is to say to a person, what is the next step that you are going to take to get to where you want to be? Last year, I was speaking at a conference and I took along with me a young friend, and I asked her whether she would like to make some announcements for me. And she said to me, well, I'm really not good in front of people. I am not a good speaker. And so I said, well, why don't you try it? It is not a huge group. Just try it, do your best. And now, a year later, she has been teaching in our training classes, and she's been one of the best teachers that we've had She's discovered a gift of teaching and loving it and thriving in it. So we want to encourage people to challenge the process and to take that next step to where they will be. So again, the five steps in raising up leaders are to model the way, to inspire a shared vision, to encourage their hearts, to enable them to act, and to challenge the process.